WPA uncertain about its future in the coalition. Woman critical after vehicle slammed into her. PPP accuses government of disrespecting the National Assembly. Money from the special project bank account must be returned to the consolidated fund. And in court, receptionist gets 36 months for fraudulent embezzlement. Those are the top headlines for Monday, June 19. Good evening, I'm Ashley Scotland with the news in details. The Government Analyst Food and Drug Department wishes to advise all importers and local manufacturers that the word vinegar must not appear on the labels of products that are solutions prepared by diluting concentrated acetic acid. According to the Law of Guyana, vinegar is a solution obtained by the acetous fermentation of an alcoholic liquid and shall contain no less than 4% or more than 12% of acetic acid, while the labels of a solution prepared by diluting concentrated acetic acid must state diluted acetic acid and not vinegar. The department has recently observed that there are several labels of locally manufactured and imported products that are actually diluted acetic acid that misleadingly bear the word vinegar. Consumers are being advised about this practice and to take a closer look at labels so that they can make an informed choice between what is vinegar and diluted acetic acid. More news still ahead, do stay tuned. Check us out at Home Sense Wholesale and Retail, 31 Traque Farm, East Bank, Demerara, for your household items such as carpets, mats, vases, stand fans, kitchen utensils, etc. We have in stock office chairs, plastic chairs, tents, outdoor patio sets, trampoline, children's wings, and much more. Also remember to check out our second branch at 93 Grove Public Road. Visit us today for the best deals and amazing prices on adult and children footwear, undergarments, children book bags, lunch bags, bicycles, beach chairs and accessories, baby care items, and a whole lot more. So the next time you're thinking about going shopping, remember to visit Home Sense Wholesale and Retail. Telephone numbers 638-6861 or 619-8502. We're standing here looking at each other,
baby. Preetas Fashions. For all your exclusive Indian wear, come to Preetas Fashions, located at 183 Bar Street, Kitty. We have a wide variety of shalwars, gararas, saris, three-piece quarter suits, bridal wear, children outfits, and accessories for all. Preetas Fashions, 183 Bar Street, Kitty. Telephone number 227-8644.
What I really love about Qualfin is that, you know, every day I get to come to work, I interact with my peers, and we have fun working towards one common goal of being the best BPO and making people's lives better.
Before Qualfin, I was working as a sales representative at an insurance company when a friend told me that Qualfin's Bedford Acton branch was hiring. At Qualfin, I get to work and study, which helps me along my path to becoming a successful human resource manager.
One of the benefits of Qualfin would definitely be the Qualfin University. I've always wanted to study computer science and I'm having the opportunity to do so right now.
A friend told me about the opening at Qualfin. I applied since I was up for the new challenge. I love working at Qualfin because of the friendly and relaxing atmosphere. It helps me to be myself.
Have a growing flesh there, and there too, and there is another one. Those ugly and annoying growing flesh, like a plague, ignoring them, and before you know, you have them everywhere. SlimJet presenting Coliomac, the most effective growing flesh and wart remover. Painlessly remove ugly growing flesh is the quick and effective way. Get soft, smooth, growing flesh-free skin, guarantee. Just apply Coliomac twice a day and the growing flesh just dry up and fall off. Easy, quick, and painless. Stop suffering and feeling embarrassed. Remove those ugly growing flesh with Coliomac. only at Slim Jet, City Mall second floor, or in New Amsterdam 22 Asylum and Main Road, Berbice.
Randolph Munir, also known as Roach, was arrested on Sunday at Eugene F. Karai International Airport, Ogle, by ranks of the Customs Anti-Narcotic Unit. Munir of Enterprise Mykonee was scheduled to board a flight destined for Barbados when he was arrested and escorted to a city hospital. While in custody, Munir excreted a total of 72 cocaine-filled pellets, weighing a total of 592 grams. According to Kanu, Munir remains in custody pending further investigations. He's expected to be placed before a magistrate on Wednesday, June 21. The Working People's Alliance is contemplating whether or not to remain in the coalition party, a partnership for national unity. This is being said as the WPA remains adamant that the government never consulted with the party before removing Dr. Rupert Rupnarine from the helm of the Education Ministry. Find out more in this report.
The Working People's Alliance executive member Dr. David Hines, during a press conference at the party's headquarters, says former Education Minister Dr. Rupert Rupnarine had met with President David Granger 2 days prior to be reassigned to a department under the Ministry of the Presidency. Dr. Hines explained that subsequently, a frank discussion on the way forward with the coalition parties was held between Dr. Rupnarine and a delegation of WPA members. Quizzed on whether the WPA thinks that it should hold a substantive ministry within the coalition government and which members should be appointed from the party, Dr. Hines had this to say.
That we did not raise with the president, that we have not discussed at any length, although we've touched on it in our executive, but we are going to develop more on that in the weeks coming, and certainly it will form part of our discussion when the APNU meets next month.
The WPA executive member maintained that the coalition government did not engage the party in 2 years. However, Saturday's meeting between President Granger has provided a turning point for the WPA. Dr. Hines believes that the members' opinion within the party has been strong on how to treat the government. He, however, opined that the party is one which questions the government of the day, given the fact that it is part of that same power.
And we have to balance that, and we've been trying to do that over the last 2 years. There are some who believe that we have erred on the side of support for government, and others who feel that we have been balanced. For us, it's not an easy task. We have always championed coalition government. From the time of Walter Rodney, who put a lot of effort into something that we call a government for national unity and reconstruction, which we put out in 1979.
The executive member noted that Dr. Rupnarine remains a senior minister within the coalition government. However, if the party is entitled to a senior ministerial portfolio, then a senior ministry should be given to the WPA. The African Cultural and Development Association AGDA executive member Tacoma Ogunseyi shared the same sentiments.
Until we hear from the president a description of the ministry and we can make a real rational judgment, you know, we want to hold on that. But I will argue that because the education ministry was such a substantive ministry, it probably had the highest spending allotment from the budget. It is hard to see how the other ministry could compare that. But we rather do it.
Dr. Hines says during the course of the 2 years, Dr. Rupnarine would attend party meetings, but never superimpose on him to divulge information from the cabinet level.
We would never put him in the awkward position of having to divulge cabinet secrets. We never asked him those things because we felt that, you know, he was there and there may be things that have to do with national security. And we never put our representative in that position. And so we never sought to impose ourselves on the education ministry, that we wanted Dr. Rupnarain to govern the ministry as a minister and not to be hamstrung by the political party.
Another meeting is scheduled for July 22, 2017, between the executive members of the WPA and President David Granger. Meanwhile, Minister of State Joseph Harmon on Friday, June 17, said that the WPA was consulted before the decision was made. Nikhil John, the reporting for MTV News Update.
As the Petroleum Commission is likely to be established soon, the Minister of Natural Resources has come in for heavy criticism from the People's Progressive Party. The party's General Secretary Barrett Jagdeo alleges that Minister Trotman will usurp the oil and gas industry as his powers will be endless. Here's Sandy Ramatar.
Leader of the People's Progressive Party, Barrett Jagdeo, says the bill signaled that the oil industry will strictly be run by politicians. Noting the bill points to a number of deficiencies, Jagdeo says the industry will be controlled and dominated as the functions of the board are being usurped by the Minister of Natural Resources, Rafael Trotman.
How large the minister looms in this commission and the powers of the minister, and that this bill seems to be designed to give a particular individual, Mr. Trotman, authority to do whatever he wanted.
This follows Trotman's behavior, which came after guidance given by the leader of the opposition on the imminent industry. According to him, Trotman's alleged livid behavior is as a result of his alleged lack of competence. The People's Progressive Party believes the government displays actions of tackiness when its alleged incompetence and lack of vision are shown.
So he could not respond to the technical issues, so he had to descend into this matter, and was allowed by the speaker, and was allowed by the speaker to do it. But I have come not to expect anything else from this speaker.
Following the passage of the bill, the Petroleum Commission will have the responsibility for ensuring policies, laws and agreements for petroleum operations are complied with. Sandy Ramutar for MTV's News Update.
Public Health Minister Volo Lawrence wants the full backing of the judiciary and the Guyana Police Force as she mulls beefing up security at medical facilities nationwide. Lawrence wants perpetrators of attacks on health workers face the full brunt of the law and be given the maximum penalty for turning health facilities into combat zones. Minister Lawrence is worried by the heightened danger faced by health workers who have been enduring sexual assaults, physical attacks and racially charged verbal threats from irate, drunken and short-tempered persons seeking medical care. Public health workers stationed at the West Emerald Regional Hospital have been the most vulnerable to assaults by patients and or their families, drawing intense governmental, regional and national concerns and criticisms. Coming up, WPA warns that the opposition is using the GCOM issue to its advantage, and PPP accused the government of disrespecting the National Assembly.
Thinking of a career as an aviation engineer? Enroll in the Art Williams and Harry Mint Aeronautical Engineering School 2018 class and watch your career take off. Find out what we've got to offer at our Open Career Day on Friday, July 7, 2017 at the CAMS Hangar, Eugene F. Curry International Airport. For more information, call 222-2155 or 222-7045 or visit our website, www.aesguyana.net. The Art Williams and Harry Went Aeronautical Engineering School, where the sky is the limit.
Here's what's happening on Waterloo Street at John Lewis Styles during the month of June. Shop for Father's Day and you could win an all-inclusive trip for two to Arrowpoint Nature Resort. Buy any men's suit and get a free tie, or buy any men's pair of shoes and get a free pair of socks. Traveling this summer, buy any luggage set and get a free travel pouch. Visit us on Waterloo Street for more choices and better prices. John Lewis Styles. Simply different.
Gapforce has been corrugating and exporting roofing sheets to all Caribbean countries since 1973. Gapforce was first to corrugate sheets, the first to introduce aluminum sheets in Guyana, the first to introduce pre-painted roofing sheets in Guyana, the first to introduce ripple and non-ripple design corrugated sheets, the first to introduce clay tile and non-clay tile corrugated sheets, and the first to introduce curve sheets. At Houston, contact Sohan on telephone number 225-6007. He'll give you all the advice you require, including what fasteners and what gauge you will need. With 42 years' experience in manufacturing corrugated roofing sheets, you can rest assured that Gaffers will supply you with quality products and at competitive prices. Get corrugated roofing sheets also from branches in Rose Hall, Bedahoacting, Neems, Parika, Kanji, and Land of Canaan. Gaffers, a name you can trust.
The news continues on MTV. The Working People's Alliance believes that the list of nominees for the GCOM chairmanship presented by the opposition leader Barrett Jagdeo is one that is provocative. Here is Nicole John with this report.
Executive member of the Working People's Alliance, Dr. David Hines, believes that the list of persons to be considered for the chairmanship of the Ghana Elections Commission, GCOM, should be impartial. The executive member says being a neutral person is the yardstick the party can work with. However, Dr. Hines added that the two lists which were submitted by opposition leader Barrett Jagdeo cannot work.
Each of those lists has included some person or persons aligned to the PPP, and we feel that that is a non-starter.
Dr. Hines says President David Granger has asked for persons on the list to be a judge among other criteria. However, the party does not consider those areas to be qualified for the position. He added that the party is concerned that the matter is being dragged out. Dr. Hines believes that President Granger should not fall trap to the opposition's alleged strategy to induce him to unilaterally select a chairman.
The PPP is playing politics. The PPP is playing politics with everything it does. And our view in the WPA is that the PPP is putting forward these lists in a very provocative way because they want to push the president to unilaterally appoint. They keep hammering at that. We are going to be opposed to appoint. So what they're doing is that they're giving him lists that he would reject with the hope that he would appoint a GCOM chairman on his own, and then he would feel, oh, so you see, that is what we were saying all along. And so in that regard, we're in solidarity with the president in terms of not falling for the PPP's trap.
President David Granger and opposition leader Barrett Jagdeo had met on two separate occasions after the list of nominees for the chairmanship of GCOM did not meet the criteria. The lists were rejected by President Granger. Currently, Jagdeo is to present a third list for consideration. Nikhil John, the reporting for MTV News Update.
The opposition party is convinced that the substance of the two-day sitting of the National Assembly on June 15 through 16 has been superseded by antics displayed by the coalition, antics that are distasteful in the mouth of the PPP.
The Granger-led administration has been accused of blatantly showing disregard and disrespect for the National Assembly by initiating what the PPP terms as a spur of lies and misleading statements.
So, they misled the parliament by sidetracking, obfuscating, arguing a different point than the one we are making, making it seem as though our motion in parliament was about challenging the right of the president to establish COIs when it had nothing to do with that.
According to him, the government is using those actions to brand the PPP negatively and is also using it as a distraction. Jagdeo says no advice was taken on the oil industry while Amerindian rights were patently being ignored. In addition to this, he believes debates from the coalition have sparked threats among the indigenous people.
A threat to Amerindian people that, hold on a minute, if you were claiming more lands in Guyana, even if it's legitimately claimed, and you get titles to those lands above the 14% that the PPP gave you, watch out, because we're going to keep all the oil and gas money here on the coast. You're not going to get any of this.
He's hopeful President David Granger will convene a press conference with urgency so as to clarify issues which he labeled as critical to the nation. Sandy Ramutar, for MTV's News Update.
The Public Accounts Committee on June 19 bashed governmental agencies as it has allegedly been proven that those agencies have time and again shown flagrant disregard for the recommendations given by the committee.
Permanent Secretary of the Department of Culture, Youth and Sports, Melissa Tucker, along with her financial advisory team, were unable to give accurate answers on items housed at a synthetic track. This follows an appearance by the Department of Culture, Youth and Sports at the Parliament Accounts Committee on June 19. Member of the PAC, Vola Lawrence, called it a theme as the previous recommendations, which have been given in 2015, have not been complied with. This, she says, has been the cause for contradictions and inaccurate answers given to the committee when questions were posed.
That even after 1 year, no attempt was made to retrieve these logbooks and say, ensure that we're following the recommendations of PAC, at least just to pretend. And this is what we've been seeing with all of the agencies coming before the Public Accounts Committee. Total disregard.
On the other hand, Chairman of the PAC, Irfan Ali, questions why sanctions are not initiated by the Ministry of Finance following the disregard for recommendations.
But this is something that we have to address. We're consistently issues raised in the AG report and issues raised by the PAC keep reoccurring without seemingly any interest in correcting the situation.
Meantime, Ministry of Finance Secretary Hector Butts committed to initiate discussions on a possible sanction at the upcoming Ministry of Finance meeting scheduled this week. Sandy Ramutar for MTV's News Update.
A nurse is in a critical condition at the New Amsterdam Public Hospital after she was struck down by an alleged speeding motor car on the Fire-ish Access Road currently in Berbice on Sunday, June 18. This newscast was told that the driver attempted to swerve from a pedestrian who was on the western side of the road, and as a result, he collided with Samson. She was flung several feet away from where she was struck. Samson was later picked up by the driver in an unconscious state and rushed to the Port Moran Public Hospital, where she was examined by a doctor who transferred her to the New Amsterdam Public Hospital as her condition was listed as critical. The driver is presently in police custody assisting with investigations. More news still ahead. Stay with us.
Nothing compares to the class and beauty of Beeson Windows and Doors. Engineered by professionals and built to last longer than the competition. Buy 10 windows and get one 24x16 bathroom window absolutely free. No tricks, no gimmicks, and no hidden fees. Prices starting from 13.5 VAT inclusive. So visit our showroom today at Lot 1228 New Eccles Industrial Site or BPAT's building on Regent Street and save big on UPVC or aluminum windows. To order now, call 622-4197 or 226-1292.
Yes is a beautiful word. It empowers us. It brings satisfaction. And since you earn up to 3% cash back on everyday purchases with the Scotiabank Gold MasterCard, that's a lot of satisfaction. A lot more often. Plus, you get a welcome bonus. Scotiabank Gold MasterCard is the card that keeps on giving, so it's easier for you to create many more precious yes moments. Apply for yours today. Call or visit a Scotiabank branch to find out more.
Sino Mall has new arrivals for you. From chic female tops to casual tops, trendy rompers, hot short pants, mini skirts, exotic lingerie, curvy jeans and leggings, nightgowns, sizzling swimwear, a world of panties to make you feel and look good. Just arrived are comfortable bras for all sizes, stylish strap bags, clutch-style purses that makes a fashion statement. And for the kids, their cartoon towels and a wide range of costume jewelry for that final touch. Come into Sino Mall today, 16 Cole Street, Georgetown, opposite Demico and the Kitty Bus Park. Call 231-8200 or 617-60...
You're still with News Update, welcome back. The Auditor General Office has recommended that all the remaining funds from the Special Project Bank account of the Department of Culture, Youth and Sport be transferred to the Consolidated Fund.
Permanent Secretary of the Department of Culture, Youth and Sports, Melissa Tucker, along with her financial advisory team on June 19, appeared before the Parliament Accounts Committee as a discussion on the 2015 Auditor General Report continues. The balance of the Special Project Bank account, which is $70 million, is short of $2 million, according to the AG's report.
Mr. Chair, this is a statement from Bank of Guyana that P.S. King would have read from. Additionally, I was advised by the accountant that reconciliation for 2015 has not yet been completed.
Following the non-transferal of funds at the ending of the year, Acting Accountant General Jennifer Chapman has recommended that the department bring urgent closure to the account. In addition to this, Chapman advised that all funds be transferred to the consolidated fund.
For any future fundings received from international donors, you can write to the Accountant General requesting approval for the opening establishing of a deposit fund account. And those transactions will be deposited to the consolidated fund, where we'll have full accountability and transparency for those transactions.
On the other hand, Chairman of PAC, Irfan Ali, lambasted the team for their own preparedness in being responsive before the committee. Disseminated after a number of questions were left unanswered. Sandy Ramutar for MTV's News Update.
The Wapishana Tribe in Region 9 has embarked on a pilot program to develop quality bilingual education for primary school students. This program is a collaborative effort between the Ministry of Education, the Ministry of Indigenous Peoples Affairs, and the Tushaus of Deep South Rupununi. The program will ensure that students with little fluency in English are taught in both their native language and English. It is also aimed at preserving the indigenous culture. First-year nursery school teachers are being trained by the end of August of this year, and actual implementation of the new bilingual textbooks will be incorporated in the September 2017 academic year. A father is pleading with his common-law wife to return home with his 3-year-old son. He claims he returned home from the interior to an empty house. Here is Nicole Jondo.
Sonny Lorinda of Diamond Housing Scheme East Bank Demerara, during an interview, says his common-law wife has run away from home with his 3-year-old son. The man, who visited MTV's office this morning, explained that he returned from the back dam only to find an empty house. Lorendo added that he left for work approximately 1 month ago and would communicate with his wife via social media.
No, I don't know what she'll get herself involved with while I'm out.
The man further added that this morning he called his mother-in-law, who lives in Region 1. However, the woman claimed that her daughter was not there.
If anybody knew whereabouts of her, let them call me. I just want my son come home. I want she come home. I want to see my son.
Lorenda is pleading with his common-law wife to return home with the child. Nikhil Jondo reporting for MTV News Update.
Stay tuned for regional and international news, court roundup, as well as the Guyana Stock Exchange.
Everything is connected: our planet, our water sources, including the water we drink. Sometimes harmful bacteria end up in our streams and canals. Although treated, the risks are high. You can prevent this pollution and contamination by maintaining your septic tank and grease traps. Call the experts at Puran Brothers Disposal Incorporated on 264-1239 or 603-5050. Keeping it clean is what we do best.
Ah!
Modern Optical Service has made it even better by introducing its budgeted spectacle line, starting as low as $10,000 for a single vision lens and $12,000 for a bifocal lens, available in tinted or clear, complete spectacles at affordable prices. So hurry down to our main office at 316 Middle Street or Lot 14 Diamond Public Road opposite Demerara Bank. Enjoy over 60 years of eye care experience at affordable prices. Modern Optical Service, your eye care professionals.
You can be a millionaire by only spending $100 on a Daily Million ticket. Simply pick any five numbers from 1 to 26, or you can buy a quick pick for your chance to win the Daily Millions. Purchase your tickets daily, Monday through Saturday, to get a chance to win $1 million every day. So, feeling lucky? Then buy a Daily Millions ticket today. Remember, a ticket today could make you rich today.
This is what went down at the Georgetown Magistrates Court on Monday, June 19.
A 36-month jail term was handed down to 28-year-old Ronella Tishona Jr. after she pleaded guilty to stealing monies from Midas Enterprises. Jr. appeared before Magistrate Judy Latchman and pleaded guilty to the charge, which stated that between March 1 and June 16 at Charles Street, Charlestown, being employed as a clerk or servant at the Midas Enterprises, she fraudulently embezzled $219,900, monies taken into her possession on account of Midas Enterprises, her employer. According to court facts, Jr. was employed at Midas Enterprises, Giddens Payday Pawn Shop, and the Princess Raven Hotel as a receptionist. She was also entrusted to collect the monies, but when the owner checked the company records, it was discovered that monies collected for the period mentioned in the charge was missing. The prosecutor said that this raised the suspicion of the owner, who reviewed the CCTV footage, which showed Jr. removing monies from a box. In his address to the court, Paul Giddings, the owner of the store, said that Jr. is in the habit of stealing monies from the business. Bail was set at a sum of $60,000 for 45-year-old Paula Gill, who was charged for allegedly assaulting her co-worker. Gill, of Lang Avenue, West Rumvel to Georgetown, pleaded not guilty to the charge, which alleged that on June 15 at Charlestown Secondary School, she unlawfully assaulted Suzette Lachan so as to cause her actual bodily harm. The defendant claimed that Lachan scrambled her first, and a fight ensued. Nevertheless, Magistrate Judy Latchman instructed Gill to make another court appearance on June 26. Lachan was also charged for allegedly assaulting Gill. A warrant has since been issued for her arrest since she failed to show up in court. Meanwhile, in another case, a charge of receiving stolen property was dismissed against the 26-year-old Paul Marvel, the owner of Ambitious Cabs. The charge against the Lotto 3 Industry Crown Dam resident alleged that between April 1 and April 30 at Norton Street, Georgetown, he received the four rims valued $120,000, property of Jermaine Blackman, knowing same to be stolen. The matter was, however, dismissed by Magistrate Judy Latchman after Blackman refused to offer evidence against Marvel. Finally, a 63-year-old minor has been sentenced to 2 years in prison by Chief Magistrate Anne McLennan on a firearm and ammunition charge. Michael Green of Duncan Street Kitty confessed that he on June 17, 2017, at Iruma Bag Dam, Cayuni River, had a 9mm pistol when he was not a licensed firearm holder. The man further accepted that on the same day and location, he had 23 rounds of matching ammunition. The unrepresented man was sentenced to 2 years imprisonment, along with a $50,000 fine on each of the charges. The sentences will run concurrently. He was also charged for making use of threatening behavior towards Vanessa Samuels. Green pleaded guilty and was fined $30,000 or default 6 weeks imprisonment. Godfrey Brooms, MTV News Update.
The Ghana Stock Exchange closing prices for trading session 726. That sums up our newscast for tonight, but before we go, here's our recap of our major headlines. WPA uncertain about its future in the coalition. Woman critical after vehicle slammed into her. PPP accuses government of disrespecting the National Assembly. Money from the Special Project Bank account must be returned to the Consolidated Fund. And in court, receptionist gets 36 months for fraudulent embezzlement. The newscast can be viewed online on MTV's Facebook page and also on our YouTube channel. The news will be rebroadcasted later tonight at 23 hours and 6 hours 30 on Tuesday, June 20. On behalf of our news team, I'm Ashley Scotland, thanking you for watching. Good night.